Quick side note, talking about the elephant in the room from last week, it's no longer the colour of salmon piss.
We've just passed over the year 20. Right now we're running parallel to what's named as Dibstall Meadow. This meadow was named after the local councillor here who had passed away. So to commemorate his services for what he'd done for the local area, this meadow that's just here, named after him.
St. Mary Cray, 7.06 kilometres. Let's get to the next station.
And this right here is Pett's Wood.
This was first recorded in 1577 in the will and testament of William Pett, who was a master shipbuilder whose family were also leading shipwrights for over 200 years. He supplied ore to shipyards on the River Thames, in particular at Deptford and Woolwich.
However, not too long after World War I, Pett's Wood was under threat.
World War I put the economy under great pressure and the government needed to make money wherever possible, and so Pett's Wood was put up for sale. Property developers were very close to purchasing the land. This didn't sit right with the locals, and so they all came together and decided to buy the land instead. It was then later donated to the National Trust. However, the threat from the developers was far from over. There was another 47 acres of woodland that was also up for sale just to the west of Pett's Wood, and the local people couldn't afford to purchase it. Someone else stepped in to purchase the land, saving it from developers. And his name was Colonel Francis Edelman. I hope I said that right. To add to his neighbouring estate at Hawkwood, this land was also donated to the National Trust 30 years later. The eastern woodland was dedicated to William Willett. But who is William Willett? Well, he was the man who founded British Summertime. William Willett was an Edwardian builder based in Chislehurst. And while out on morning walks, he could never understand why it was that when the sun had risen, how it was that people could continue to sleep. And so, in 1907, he published a pamphlet named A Waste of Daylight, which had suggested altering the time by 20 minutes on each of the four Sundays in a row in order to minimise the disruption to biological clocks. Due to its complicated implementation, the House of Commons initially rejected the idea. However, by 1916, British Summertime was finally implemented. One of the major catalysts at the time being World War I. Some of the benefits at the time included additional productivity and reduced coal usage. British Summertime was a perfect way to also minimise costs. Unfortunately, this was a year too late, as by the age of 58, William Willett had unfortunately passed away due to the flu, and he never saw his idea of British Summertime ever come to fruition. And that brings us to this monument here as a memorial for William Willett. But if you look at the sundial just at the back of the memorial, you'll see that it is permanently set to British Summertime. There has been a lot of conversation recently with regard to British Summertime, whether it should be a permanent fixture so we don't go back an hour during winter. There's also been some conversation about splitting up time zones around the United Kingdom, so to have Scotland dip into that of England. However, you can't deny the impact that William Willett has on British summer as we know it as today. I could make my life a million times easier by taking this shortcut here. That'll take me over to Pett's Wood. However, we still need to stop by Bickley and then come back on ourselves over to Pett's Wood. If you come to stand at this spot here, you get to see all the different bridges just down here. And then if you keep on following Goss Hill Road, that will bring you to Chislehurst Station. But we're not going there. At least not today. 16.8 kilometres, we've made it to Bickley Station. When the station first opened, this was known as Southborough Road. But then in 1860, the name had changed to Bickley. So where I'm running now is Jubilee Country Park. It's a local nature reserve, as well as it being a metropolitan importance for nature conservation. This area was purchased by Bromley Council in 1977 and opened in 1981, I believe, to celebrate the Silver Jubilee of the Queen, hence the name of Jubilee Country Park. On that note, let's get over to Pett's Wood Station. National Rail sign is a little bit underloved, but we're here at Pett's Wood. Right, let's get to last station of the day, Orpington. 21.90 kilometres, we're coming up to Orpington. The finish is in sight.
Yes.
That was a good blast through the tunnel. I couldn't not do that.
So just made it to Orpington, 22.82 kilometres since 2008. This station is step three.
Which, by the way, I am thinking of making it almost like a mini documentary about the state of accessibility on the railways and how it needs to be much better. So if that is something that you are interested in, do let me know. But if you made it to the end of this video, thank you so much. If you want to watch more videos, check out the Runderground playlist as well as two other videos right here.